Hello, Chris Green here with the Flood Insurance Guru.
If you've got questions about flood insurance, flood education, flood zone changes, elevation certificates, click below to visit our website, floodinsuranceguru.com. You can also check out our daily flood education videos on our YouTube channel. Remember, we have an educational background on flood mitigation, which means we can help you understand flood risks like this right here, your flood insurance, and mitigate your property long term to help you minimize flood losses and flood premiums.
And today we're talking about why your flood insurance didn't go down when you lowered the coverages on your building. Or maybe you increased the coverages on your building, but your rate didn't change. Why is that? More than likely, this was with a private flood insurance company. And what happens in these situations is these companies have what's called tierings. So you might have the same price for coverage from $150,000 to $200,000. But when you get to $225,000 is when you see the jump. You know, we've seen this a lot where people are like, hey, why am I paying so much more for $225,000 in coverage compared to $200,000? It's because of some of these tiering systems with private flood insurance companies of how they base their rates. So it's important to pay attention to this. You know, so if you're putting flood insurance on a building from $100,000 to $150,000 or $150,000 to $200,000 or more than $250,000, you could possibly jump up two or three tiers, causing significant increase. And so this might be why. So if you've got questions about how to better understand these tiering systems, you know, what's the right coverage for your property? Click below to visit our website, floodinsuranceguru.com. Remember, we have an educational background on flood mitigation, which means we can help you understand flood risks like this right here, your flood insurance, and mitigating your property long term. Thank you.